Do you sometimes wonder what constellations are in the night sky? Well, just look up and we'll walk you through the sky tonight. We'll start by looking west, an hour or so after sunset. See that bright object above where the sun went down? It doesn't twinkle, and that's because it's the planet Venus. Venus is currently the closest planet to the Earth and reflects the light from the Sun very brightly. As we move into our night sky, we'll begin with our zodiacal constellations. The first is Gemini, the twins, with the two bright stars Castor and Pollux, followed by Cancer, the crab, and Leo, the lion, with the bright star Regulus. Next up is Virgo, the maiden. The bright star Spica sits at her knee, but there's something even cooler near her head. This is where the Event Horizon Telescope team aimed their telescopes in order to take the first picture of a black hole located in the galaxy M87. This elliptical galaxy is 53 million light years away and was discovered in 1781 by Charles Messier. Finally, Libra, the scales, will round out our zodiac constellations. Next is Corvus the crow, which according to Action Comics number 14 is where you can find Superman's home planet of Krypton. Corvus sits in the southern sky with Crater the cup and Hydra the water snake, the largest constellation in the sky. Now we're going to turn ourselves around 180 degrees to look towards the north. The first object we'll look for is actually not a constellation, but an asterism. It's the Big Dipper. An asterism is an easily recognizable pattern or group of stars that we can use to help us find other things in the sky. We can use the Big Dipper by following the two stars at the end of the bowl down to Polaris, our North Star, located in the handle of the Little Dipper. These asterisms represent parts of larger constellations. The Big Dipper is part of Ursa Major, the Big Bear. See the second star in the Big Bear's tail? This is a double star, or a pair of stars, called Mizar and Alcor. They're also known as the Horse and Rider. They're so close together that you can just barely make out that there are two separate stars. Ursa Minor, the Little Bear, is a much simpler constellation. We simply close the lid on the Little Dipper. Snaking between the two bears is Draco, the dragon. See that bright star in the northwest? That's Capella, located in the constellation Auriga, the charioteer. Hiding between Auriga and the bears is one very strange constellation. Its name is Camelopardalis. And no, it's not a camel, but rather a giraffe. It's also faint and not very easy to see. And this is why imaginations are really important when looking at the night sky. We'll find our last two constellations by making our way back up towards Ursa Major and using the tail of the bear to make an arc to the star Arcturus. This will help us find Bootes, the herdsman. And just to the east of Bootes, we'll find everyone's favorite strongman, Hercules, the hero. These are just some of the things you can see in the night sky during the month of May. As we get later into the month, we'll be able to see the planet Jupiter rising in the east before midnight. We'll also get to observe the full flower moon on the evening of May 6th into the morning of May 7th. So head outside and look up. And don't forget to tag us on Twitter and Instagram with any pictures you take while you're outside looking up at the sky. Just use hashtag ScienceSnacks. We hope to see you next month for Space Bites. Stay hungry.